As a young woman, I was too excitable, too nervous. I couldn't settle myself down. I didn't sit. I started meditating in 1980 in December, so that's quite a few years ago. I decided to try meditating, and I tried it on my own. I would make a challenge to myself to meditate for 10 minutes. Lars and I went to Sri Lanka, and it was there in Asia that I first saw the Buddhist sculpture and the architecture. And it hit me hard. I really was impressed by it. I got turned on to Buddhism through sculpture. In Japan, they have the story of the Buddha. Lars and I started reading the story of the Buddha to each other out loud.
The emptiness of all five conditions and was freed of pain.
Form is no other than emptiness.
Emptiness, no other than form.
For me, it was like reading the truth. Buddhism has influenced my creativity. I've painted many images inspired by the teachings. Meditation is concentration, and that helps me in my work to be able to focus myself. Watercolor is really focusing and focusing on what you see. I created sculptures. So meditation has allowed me to be able to concentrate, focus myself. This is the Sky Museum, where we have great dinners together with friends, good light for painting. Should I explain what I'm doing?
Sure.
Okay. Every month, I create a new painting every day, and every month I choose a subject for that month. For example, one month inspired by Brad Beldner, I chose chickens. He likes chickens and he visits a house in Santa Clara.
Los Altos
that adopts elderly chickens. So then I decided, hey, chickens might be a good idea for the month. And what I like to do is create a list of idioms, expressions, phrases, things that are more than just bantam. I like to also use landscapes, so I try to put my idioms and expressions to happen in a landscape or with a landscape. This is the month of March. I create my list, and then every day I pick one phrase or expression. Like, this is Little Red Rooster. And I put him in a Tuscan landscape. Which came first? This little chicken is checking out his egg on a beach in Maui. Crossing the road, and these three guys are crossing the road at Foothills Park. This is Mother Hen, and I put her on a lotus leaf. This is a spring chicken. And here I use collage. I like to do mixed media. All your eggs in one basket. For you Palo Alto people, this is the Stanford dish. Cock of the walk. And here we're back in Foothill Park for a hen party. I'm a member of a writing group. Every week we write, but I paint. The prompt that evening was faith.
So I did a Madonna and Child as a hen and her chick. Early Bird, that's Dawn at the Baylands. Foothill Park again, Laying an Egg. This is Cracked Up. Rooster Tail. Cocktail. This is Flew the Coop. I was inspired by the feral chickens in Maui, and so I put him over the ocean in Maui. Cockfight, I was thinking Mexico Southwest, so I put them in maybe Sedona or Scottsdale. There's a little red hen. Chicken Out, there's a chicken thinking about going surfing, but not really. And finally, inspired by the tulips and the flowers at Filoli, I did Peep, little chicky. And that's 1 month. I base my work on the rules that Natalie Goldberg, who is a fabulous writer, she encourages you to do writing every day and writing from a prompt. Her rules are, feel free to write the worst shit in America. Suspend the judge. Take it where it goes. I have an extra rule, which is to take suggestions. Everybody can help. Now I'm thinking of doing house furniture. Well, the first one I thought of was recliner. What I immediately think is gorgeous nude reclining in a landscape, which turns me on. And then I use Brewer's Dictionary of Phrases and Fables. Monday, this is Monday. So Monday's Child. They just have all these references to Monday or money. And then the other thing I do is trusty old Google. I Googled idiot expressions using furniture vocabulary. And then I look through them and I see if anything turns me on. Darken one's door sounds good. Bring it to the table. Memory like a sieve. That's a good one. Rug rat.
Cutting a rug?
Cut a rug might be good. Okay, so we need a couple of more. Okay, I've got 29. So I have one for every day this month. Thinking about a reclining person. So we look for where would we put that person? I don't know. You're not reclining on a puddle. Or she could be reclining in a flower. She could recline on a lily pad. Do you ever recline with your head down? Okay, so there's this bed of flowers, and here's her legs, and the hands here. Do I like that? This is the hard part. This is part of the process. If I lay another line of watercolor next to that, it'll just ooze right up into the sky. So I have to wait for the sky to dry. It's gone out. This is the altar to Lars Speyer, my former husband.
And from what I understand, Lars was a pretty amazing and prolific artist.
He was a photographer and a mentor for many people. He helped people. If you had an idea, you could come and discuss it with him, and he'd help you clarify your project and then say, okay, let's go to the store and get some of the stuff for it. And he'd help you buy it, or he'd just take you there. He'd make he'd get you started, he'd get you off your rump and get you going. This is a big painting that I did called Vilandri. So here's this very civilized garden, and then there's a leopard in it. In watercolor, you go from light to dark. I know I'm going to be putting light things in here. Thank you. That's just going to be a problem. Well, c'est la vie. This one is the beginning of the month of February, in which I took the theme of objects. And I painted a reclining woman in the field in Italy, in Tuscany. This one has toadstools. The mushroom I used is the amanitas. This is something new. Toothpaste. Waking up. It's a landscape from a photo that I took at Stanford. Bookends. Inspiration. For me, my dreams are my inspiration. So here am I dreaming in my dream. Tablecloth. I love the Southwest. This is a waterbed. Lizard. The hills in back of Lake Boronda. Saw this giant iguana there. This is a takeoff on Madame Recamier, except I substituted sweet potato. Madame Sweet Potato Recamier. Lay on the table. Love seat. Well, I guess vinyl's coming back now. Turntables. This is be part of the furniture. In the oven. It's a casserole landscape. This is plane and tools. Clean sheets. Mind like a sieve. Oops. Chest of drawers. This is sideways. Cutting the rug. Music. When I was little, we had a player piano and brought back memories. It's a racing car. And then here's the final one, lobster. And I took the liberty of using a landscape a la Georgia O'Keeffe. When I started, I was really excited about drawing and everything, but boy, I got a cramp in my hand from holding the brush because I didn't know how to hold it right. And I got a backache because I was bending over and being so tense about it. From years of painting and stuff, I know that I have to limber enough to be able to paint or to move around. I mean, Feldenkrais is all about awareness through movement. It's very similar to moment-to-moment awareness in meditation. Feldenkrais just helps you be aware of your body and loosen up your body and body awareness. When you're sitting on the cushion, you're aware of your thoughts, but you're also aware of your sensual input from your eyes, ears, nose, body. So it's awareness. I guess I'm really interested in awareness.
That's a lot. You can edit that.
Okay. I think that's probably good. You definitely said some awesome things about it.
So this is a list of all kinds of things regarding hats. Mad Hatter, hat rack, cat in the hat, put your hat in the ring, dunce cap, rabbit out of the hat. But then I woke up this morning and it didn't turn me on. So we'll save it for another time.